in the name of God, the most gracious, the most merciful. Today, we have a very intense topic. I am going to shed some light on. And the topic is, Islam is the pioneer of humanity. Audience, the word Islam is an Arabic word, which means peace, not only for the followers of Islam, but for all mankind.
Peace is the backbone and an essential element for establishing a prosperous, vibrant and stable global society. Islam always stresses on peaceful coexistence and cooperation among the diverse communities. It attempts to construct those settings of social life without which no man can pursue in general to be himself at his best. Islam laid the foundation of a system in which the people were created as their children and vigorously fought for the rights of the oppressed of all nations. Social change and economic development were restored by eradicating caste-based inequality and dishonesty by establishing solidarity among the backward and upper classes. Islam has always had a tradition the implementation of good over personal interests. When Muslim armies came to India from the West, the principles of human equality were so strong that they would go back. Muhammad Ghori made one of his purchased slaves the Sultan of the country. Fair justice of Muslims along with all people. Perhaps the biggest reason that we never find in the historical record of any resistance and protest by the people during Muslim rule. Islam stresses the equality between men and women and gave them the right to own property and to vote. The Quran makes it clear that sole basis for superiority of any person over another is piety and righteousness, not gender, color, or nationality. There is no decree in Islam that forbids women from seeking employment whenever there is a necessity for it, as demonstrated by the Prophet's wife Khadija, who was a businesswoman. Islam promotes peace in legislation and practice. The idea of peace is deeply rooted in the daily life of Muslims, as evidenced by the way in which they greet each other, saying Assalamu alaikum and Wa alaikum assalam, meaning peace be upon you and peace be upon you too, respectively. The concept of jihad. Quran states, and as for those who strive in our path, we will surely guide them in our ways. And indeed, Allah is with those who are of service to others. According to Quran, it is actual concept of jihad. Its literal meaning is to struggle or strive with a particularly admirable purpose. Jihad is a personal endeavor to be a better human being by overcoming evil forces within oneself. Military-based jihad is only to be conducted with an Islamic scholar's permission and only when the religion and humanity are threatened and all attempts at negotiation and peacemaking have failed. Islam condemns terrorism and disturbing social order against any creature. The term terrorism and Islam are contradictory. One cannot be a true Muslim and terrorist at the same time. The Quran states, whosoever kills a human being, it shall be as if he has killed all mankind. And whosoever saves the life of one, it shall be as if he had saved the life of all mankind. After messengers, peace be upon him, migrated to Medina. Firstly, he established a cordial brotherly relationship between the inhabitants of Medina, called Ansar, and the immigrants of Mecca called Muhajirin, who migrated with the messenger, peace be upon him, after they were persecuted by the pagans of Mecca. There were 22 tribes of Portuguese and Arabs that always remained in a constant state of war with each other. messenger, peace be upon him, maintained his position as a pacifist preacher and neither adopted the form of a based religious fanatic nor forced others to accept Islam. Even that he had enough military strength. Quite contrarily, he adopted the same way of pacifying the centuries-long enemies of Medina, and at last ended the enmity between Aus and Khazraj that lasted for round about 120 years. Moreover, he established alliance with the pagans of Jewish of Medina as well. For this purpose, when an Islamic state established, the pact is called Pact Charter of Medina. It is considered the first social contract and written constitution of the civilized world and history of humanity. Please imagine Mecca, whereas the Prophet and his companions were tortured in many ways. After conquering Mecca, Prophet Muhammad said to the oppressors, "Not there by you, today you go at large." Then he started to address the people. After truly praising Allah, "O people, Allah has eliminated the things you took pride in during the period of ignorance and the pride you took in your forefathers. There are now only two types of people. One is the righteous person with fear of Allah, who is honored in the sight of Allah, and the other is the sinful wretch, who is insignificant in Allah's sight." Allah says, "O people, we have certainly created you from a single male and female, and made you into various nations and tribes so that each person may know where he belongs and who others are. Your differences in lineage and race do not give any of you superiority over others. Verily, the most honored of you in Allah's sight is the one with the most taqwa." Prophet Muhammad said in a part of his last sermon on the 9th day of Dhul Hijjah in Arafat. This sermon is also known as Khutbah Hajjatul Wida. "O people, lend me an attentive ear, for I don't know whether after this year I shall ever be amongst you again. Therefore, listen to what I am saying to you carefully, and take these words to those who could not be present here today. O people, just as you regard this month, this day, and this city as sacred, so regard the life and property of every Muslim as a sacred trust. Return the goods entrusted to you to their rightful owners. Hurt no one so that no one may hurt you. Remember that you will indeed meet your Lord, and that he will indeed reckon your deeds. Allah has forbidden you to take usury. Therefore, all interest obligations shall henceforth be waived. O people, it is true that you have certain rights with regard to your women, but they also have right over you. If they abide by your right, then to them belongs the right to be fed and clothed in kindness. Do treat your women well and be kind to them, for they are your partners and committed helpers. And it is your right that they do not make friends with anyone of whom you do not approve, as well as never to commit adultery. O people, no prophet or apostle will come after me, and no new faith will be born. Reason well. Therefore, O people, and understand my words which I convey to you. I leave behind me two things, the Quran and my example, the Sunnah, and if you follow these, you will never go astray." The Holy Quran and Hadith literature reveals the fact that Islam supports universal peace and affluence. Believers, let not some men among you ridicule others. It may be that the latter are better than the former, nor should some women laugh at others. It may be that the latter are better than the former. Do not defame or be sarcastic to each other, or call each other by offensive. How bad it is to earn an evil reputation after accepting the faith. Those who do not repent are evildoers. Believers, avoid much suspicion. Indeed, some suspicion is a crime, and do not backbite. Would any of you like to eat his dead brother's flesh? No, you would hate it.
Fear God. God is ever forgiving and most merciful.
For you is your religion, and for me is my religion. There shall be no compulsion in acceptance of the religion. Let not the enmity and hatred of others make you avoid justice. Be just, that is next to piety. A graceful word and forgiving is better than charity followed by causing hurt. Allah is all independent, forbearing. Do not oppress the offense and do not reject the beggars. Let there be a community among you who invite to all that is good, enjoining what is right and forbidding what is wrong, and those will be the successful. The servants of God are those who walk on the earth in humility, and when the ignorant address them, they say, peace. You shall worship none but him, and you shall be kind to your parents. If one or both of them live to their old age in your lifetime, you shall not say to them any word of contempt nor rebel them, and you shall address them in kind words. Be moderate in your walking and your talking. The most unpleasant sound is the praying of donkeys. My people, be just in your wagon and measuring. If you want retaliation, let it be equal to that which you faced. But if you exercise patience, it will be better for you. And they feed for the love of Allah, the needy, the orphan, and the captive. Prophet Muhammad, we have sent you for no other reason but to be a mercy for mankind. Say, O my servants, who have transgressed against their souls, despair not of the mercy of Allah, for Allah forgives all sins. He is truly the most forgiving, most merciful. And as for him who seeks your help, reject not. None of you truly believes until he loves for his brothers what he loves for himself. Who makes peace between people by inventing good information or saying good things is not a liar. The best of you is he who is best to his wife. Paradise is under the feet of the mothers. The compassionate one has mercy on those who are merciful. If you show mercy to those who are on the earth, he who is in the heaven will show mercy to you. O just people, H.G. Wells says in his book Outline of History, the Islamic teachings have left great tradition of equitable and gentle dealings and behavior, and inspire people with nobility and tolerance. These are human teachings of the highest order, and these teachings sprout into existence a society in which hard-heartedness and collective oppression and injustice were the least as compared with all other societies preceding it. Islam is replete with gentleness, courtesy, and fraternity. The reader must keep in mind that H.G. Wells is among those others who have made many derogatory remarks about Prophet Muhammad. The fact that even the sworn enemies of Islam have no choice but to accept the greatness of Islam in one way or the other. Godfrey Higgins compared the attitude of Christian marauders with the Muslim conquerors. In all the history of the caliphs, there cannot be shown anything half as infamous as the Inquisition. Nor a single instance of an individual burnt for his religious opinion. Nor do I believe put to death in a time of peace for simply not embracing the religion of Islam. Thus, this was the impact of the teachings of the Muhammad gave to the Muslims, that Islam is not a religion of force, pressure, and compulsion. It is a faith or belief by heart. With this paragraph, Higgins refuted those who demonstrated Islam as religion of terrorism and Prophet Muhammad, peace be upon him, as founder of religion of tyranny and arrogance.
Swami Vivekananda says,
take Muhammadanism, for instance, as soon as a man becomes a Muhammadan, the whole of Islam receives him as a brother with open arms, without making any distinction, which no other religion does. If one of your American Indians becomes a Muhammadan, the Sultan of Turkey would have no objection to dine with him. In this country, I have never yet seen a church where the white man and the Negro can kneel side by side to pray. Just think of that. Islam makes its followers all equal. So that, you see, is the peculiar excellence of Muhammadanism. Dr. Ambedkar states that the combination of the religion of Islam is very strong for humanity. It is known to all. No other social association can contest the tenacity of Islamic Brotherhood. In one of his speeches, Patit Pawan Das said, Islam is a complete and universal religion that treats all its followers equally. That is why 7 crore untouchables are thinking to leave Hinduism. And that is why Gandhiji's son, Harilal, had also converted to Islam. It was not a sword that had so much influence in Islam, but in fact, it was the truth and equality which Islam teaches. Periyar E.V. Ramaswamy Nekkar said, friends, the disease of Shudrapan is our terrible disease. It is similar to cancer. There is only one medicine for this, and that is Islam. If we did not accept Islam, we would have to live life as deodorant did. Ramaswamy stated that Islam was founded to end polytheism and inequality based on birth. One was to establish the doctrine of God and human equality, to eliminate all blind beliefs and idol worship, and it was established to provide leadership to lead a rational, intelligent life. Oh my just people, being kind and loving all, together these concepts form the essence of what the Quran teaches. These concepts are not just ideas. They are an active way of life. Failure to bring forth and focus on the core concepts of Islam has led to misunderstanding and misuse of this religion. Unfortunately, we regularly see news articles play a large part in perpetuating the fear and lack of understanding about Islam. So now, the conversation should be open to all. Break down barriers between Muslims and non-Muslims. This will help to disprove the claims from extremist groups that religion supports their ideas. And this will help people to understand that violence and terrorism is not part of the religion of Islam. Instead, Islam fosters peace and hope.
Thanks for watching.
There is a need, like, now more than ever, for the participation of everyone to support Islam towards achieving global peace.